Welcome back to my channel. This is Sir Paya. Sa mga bago pa lang sa channel ko, ako po ay nagtuturo ng basic programming kung paano gumawa ng system from the scratch. So don't forget to subscribe my channel and pakipindot na rin sa notification bell para ma-update kayo sa mga bagong upload ko tulad nito. So update tayo sa ginawa nating POS and inventory system using C# and SQL Server Database. Okay, so dito, so magdagdag tayo dito ng vendor. Kulang tayo dito ng vendor at saka yung stock adjustment. Okay? So, first, add muna tayo ng another table. Then we have the vendor ID or the ID. And so, this is a primary key. Tapos naka auto increment, and then the vendor name, address, a telephone number, give the contact person. Then the email address, then the fax. Okay, then save. We have a TVL vendor. Okay. This is definitely yeah. Then change natin yung icon. So, palitan natin. Hanap tayo dito ng icon. User. Ayan, so we have a vendor. Okay. Ayan. So, after sa vendor, gawa rin tayo ng stock adjustment na module. So, sa module na yan, doon tayo mag remove or mag add ng stock. So, if ever hindi magtalin yung actual inventory natin at saka inventory ng system, then add tayo ng customer. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Add tayo dito ng add. And then new item. Tapos Windows form. Add tayo ng FRM vendor. Okay. Single, remove the text, start a position, center, or center screen. Then we have the control box, set to false. Yan. So, copy lang natin to. This is a window details. Then this is this the dispose. So dito na check natin yung the vendor. Address, contact person, then you have the address. Telephone email box. So naming tayo, so this is a TXT box. Text email, text telephone, text contact or person, text address, text vendor. Okay, so yan, copy natin yan. Gawin natin dito. Yan. So, kung tayo dito using system.tita.sql client. Natin ang variable SQL connection. SQL connection. Getting the dimensionship again. SQL command CM. Ayan. Tapos the database connection with the DB connection. DB. New DB connection. Set with the CM. New SQL connection and that connection string db dot my connection. Then copy natin yung title. So may title ba dito? Natin. Wala pala. Wala tayong nilagay na title dito. Anyway, so continue tayo. Web vendor. So vendor din, save tayo ng data for vendor. Supply print catch exception ay x pcm dot close then message box dot show dot message warning yung title niya message box button dot ok message box icon dot warning. Okay, then you have the cn.open cn.close cn new sql command we have insert into then in the table we have the tbl window so under the table window the vendor ID or the vendor address contact person telephone email and we have the box and the values. We have a cm.parameters.add with value and ang value ng ating vendor. So we have a txt vendor.txt. We have the address. Then you have the contact person, this is the contact person. Then you have the telephone. Email. And the email, and then the last one is the box number. And this is txt box, txt email. So this is email. Txt telephone, txt person, txt address vendor, and of course cm.execute ng query. Add tayo dito ng procedure, public void, ito natin, txt address, txt email, txt box, txt person, txt telephone number, txt vendor, and txt vendor dot focus detain save dot enable true detain update dot enable false. Okay, then message box that show record has been successfully saved. Mount tayo dito if this is buffer Gotcha. Refund. Click yes to confirm. So try natin. Okay, so the dashboard and then the bin door. Try and think what the bin door. For example, the bin door is save natin. Save this record. Yes, record is fully saved. So, try natin kung nag-save yung record natin dito. So, replace mo natin to. And then, go to the bin door. Tapos, display record. So, ayan, nag-save na tayo na. Well, nakasave na tayo ng record. Okay? Again, maraming salamat sa iyong panonood. So, I hope may natutunan kayong bago. Ayan. So, next tutorial natin. So, ang gagawin natin is i-retrieve natin yung data from the database dito sa ating MS SQL server to the data grid view. Okay? Then, next tutorial rin natin, so, i-update natin yung record at saka i-delete natin yung record. Okay, so, yun yung gagawin natin. Again, maraming salamat sa inyong panood. Please support this channel. Happy coding!